how to teach you, you know, starting no matter whether you are in Form 4 this year or Form 5, next year Form 4 or next year Form 5, you don't have to worry, because if you are with him, you are on the right track to score your A+. Okay, so without further ado, I'd like to invite Cikgu Sri Lam to take over the stage. Cikgu, you can just turn on your video and audio. Okay. Okay, Cikgu Sri Lam, over to you.
Okay, thank you. Hi, students. Hi, everyone. About 24 of you in this group now. I'm Mr. Sri Lam. You can go through my biodata. Okay, I'm from Penang, so straight on from Penang. Okay, you can see my anugerah-anugerah yang pernah saya terima sepanjang perkhidmatan sebagai seorang guru prinsip perakaunan. Anugerah ikon akademik, anugerah guru inovatif peringkat kebangsaan, anugerah guru inovatif peringkat negeri Pulau Pinang, anugerah guru cemerlang pengajaran dan pembelajaran, Best Accounting Teaching Practice Award by LCCI, Anugerah Guru Mutiara Cemerlang PPD Timur Laut, Anugerah Guru Cemerlang Curriculum, Anugerah Perkhidmatan Cemerlang. Jadi untuk pengetahuan pelajar-pelajar, saya akan cuba sedaya upaya untuk membantu anda untuk meningkatkan prestasi anda dalam mata pelajaran prinsip perakaunan. Saya percaya di sini ada pelajar tingkatan 3 yang baru nak belajar tentang prinsip perakaunan tahun depan. Ramai tak pelajar daripada tingkatan 3? Yang sedang ikuti sesi kita hari ini. Ada? Okay, ramai juga ya. Okay, of course you want to know what are we going to study in accounts? What is accounts? What actually am I going to study in 2 years time? Right? Okay, I'm going to tell you today apa kepentingan kita belajar prinsip perakaunan. Why we have to study this subject? What am I going to study in this subject for 2 years? Berkesan tak subjek ini? Sesuai tak subjek ini untuk saya? Baik, when we talk about accounts, apa yang kita belajar dalam perakaunan? What do you learn? Mungkin ada pelajar form 4 yang can share. What actually you learn in accounting? Timbangan duga. Okay. Lagi? What is the purpose of learning all this imbangan duga, persamaan perakaunan? What is the main purpose of learning accounting? Yes, very good, Joyce. The main purpose of learning accounting is just simple. Untuk cari untung atau rugi. That's all. In accounting, we are going to teach you how to count untung atau rugi bagi sesebuah perniagaan. But straight away, you won't be able to find untung atau rugi. Tak boleh. There are step by step that you have to learn before you could count untung atau rugi. So in Form 4, when you go to Form 4, we will teach you from beginning bagaimana kumpul dokumen-dokumen perniagaan. What is receipt? What is invoice? We will teach you all that first. Based on all that documents, how to record into accounting books. The last stage only we are going to find untung atau rugi. That is the main purpose of learning accounting. So in Form 4, you will start from beginning, collecting information until when you come to Module 8, Chapter 8, then only you find untung atau rugi. After that, in Chapter 9, we will teach you how to do correction. If you make mistake in finding your untung atau rugi, how to do correction. Chapter 9. So, all together in Form 4, you have 9 chapters. 9 module. Just to count, untung atau rugi. Senang tak? Belajar untuk kira untung atau rugi. But you must exactly know how to count untung atau rugi. Orang yang tak belajar accounts dengan orang yang belajar accounts, cara kira untung tak sama. If you don't learn accounting, you will count untung tak sama dengan orang yang kira untung, orang yang sudah belajar perakaunan. You understand? Saya bagi you satu simple question. Kita tengok pelajar form 4 yang sudah belajar accounts dengan pelajar form 3 yang belum belajar accounts, you will come out with different kind of answer. Shall we try? We try one question. Nah, kita cuba satu soalan. I give you a simple question. This one anyone also can find. Hopefully you can see my screen. Untung. If you want to find untung, it's very simple. You take hasil. Hasil means duit masuk minus belanja. Income minus expenses, you will get untung. I give you one simple question. Let's say my jualan, my sales, 80,000. Expenses that I have to pay. I have to pay. Kadar bayaran is bills that I have to pay. I have to pay. Okay, let's say these are the amount that I have to pay. But gaji, instead of paying 7,000, I only paid 6,000. Sudah bayar. This one, kena bayar. Kadar bayaran, I have to pay 3,000. I have paid 4,000. Insurance, I have to pay 5,000. I have paid 6,000. Now, please tell me how much is untung. Hasil minus belanja. Your hasil is jualan. Jualan is your income. This one, your expenses. Can you find untung atau rugi? Ling Hao Ki. You are form 3 student or form 4 student? Form 3, good try. Very simple. Untung is hasil minus belanja. Junbei, 65,000. You have paid. This one, you have to pay. $66,000, Winnie Wong. Joyce, rugi. Zin Lin, you see? 65. Untung, 64. Adeline, okay. All right, no problem. Listen. Accounting is a professional subject. Prinsip account adalah subjek profesional. Professional means what? Soalan prinsip account, kalau dijawab di Malaysia, di India, di China, di Amerika, di mana pun, answer mesti sama. If I post this question in internet, ask people to find how much is untung, you all must get the same answer. That's why it's a professional subject. No matter where you are, you must get the same answer. Sebab kita ikut satu peraturan perakaunan yang sama, prinsip perakaunan yang sama. So that's why in accounts, we will teach you the proper way of finding untung. Orang yang tak belajar perakaunan, they will take my hasil is 80,000. They will minus whatever they have paid, sudah bayar. So they take 646. They minus 16,000, they get 64,000. This is any common people will do. For them, expenses minus whatever I have paid, that is my untung. But that is not the right answer. Because in accounting, you kena guna prinsip-prinsip yang ditetapkan. Apabila kita mengira untung atau rugi, kita mesti guna prinsip pengiktirafan hasil dan belanja. Pengiktirafan hasil dan belanja means you have to minus belanja yang you kena bayar. The actual amount that you are supposed to pay, not the amount that you have paid. For example, gaji. I'm supposed to pay 7,000, but I only paid 6,000. You still need to minus 7,000. Because somehow that 1,000 you have to pay. So you count earlier. In kadabaran, 3,000, but I have paid 4,000. You have to take 3,000. Insurance, 5,000 supposed to pay, but I paid overpaid 6,000. You have to minus 5,000. So 80,000 minus 15,000, the untung is 65,000. This one orang yang sudah belajar perakaunan. Ini orang yang belum belajar perakaunan. Okay, my question is, any Form 4 students got 64,000? Jujur, raise your hand. Berapa orang Form 4 students get 64,000? It shows clearly your basic accounting is not strong. Sebab you tidak didedahkan dengan cara mengira yang betul di sekolah. You tidak apply konsep prinsip andaian yang you sudah belajar dalam perakaunan. So when you study accounting, to count untung atau rugi, that is a proper way of counting. Faham? Jelas pelajar-pelajar? So ada yang dapat 64,000, ada yang dapat 65,000 just now, right? Now why? You will know. So that is what we are going to learn. In accounting, we are going to learn how to kira untung atau rugi. Okay, in Form 4, we already taught you how to count untung atau rugi. What are we going to study in Form 5 then? Yeah, learning accounting is fun, really fun. So in Form 4, we teach you how to count untung atau rugi for small companies, milikan tunggal, kedai runcit, kedai gunting rambut, minimarket, how to count untung atau rugi. But when you go to Form 5, we will teach you how to analyze. You sudah kira untung. We want to know whether this company is performing or not. Untung 10,000, untung 20,000, performing or not? Can they sustain in the market for another 20 years? That one we will teach you in Form 5. Analysis, yes, Joyce is answering. Nisbah semasa, nisbah keberuntungan. On top of that, not only analyzing untung atau rugi itu berkesan atau tidak, kita juga akan ajak awak mengira untung atau rugi untuk perniagaan-perniagaan yang lebih besar seperti perkongsian, syarikat berhad, kelab persatuan and all that in Form 5. So pelajar-pelajar Form 4, you are going to have so much fun learning accounting, tak rugi belajar perakaunan. Sooner or later, bila you jadi seorang peniaga, you can prepare your own account or people working under you takkan tipu you sebab you pun tahu prinsip account. You pun sudah belajar selok-belok mengira. Okay, next question. Why companies tak suka declare untung yang banyak? If you are an accountant of a company, you are glad to see your untung. Company's untung 1 million. You're very happy. You go and tell your boss, boss, our company dapat untung 1 juta. You are happy. But your boss is not happy. Your boss say, hey, 1 million now. Okay, don't declare. Don't show 1 million. Huh? Why? Why is he not happy? when you as an accountant, you are happy that your company dapat untung sebanyak 1 juta. Why? Who can answer? Yes. If you declare more untung, you have to pay more tax. If you declare lesser untung, you pay less tax. So, can we manipulate the accounts? Boleh tipu kah? Ayo, I'm afraid dah to show untung yang banyak. Can I declare untung yang sedikit? You cannot tipu. Tipu salah. Penyelewengan. Tak boleh. But your boss is not happy with 1 million untung. We teach you in accounting, we teach you how not to show untung yang banyak. We will teach you. People who don't study accounting, they don't know all that. All that secret, they don't know. And sometimes in school, teacher also teach you, but then they don't actually tell you, oh, this is the way. How? How to declare lesser when the actual untung is more? You will study. We will teach you in chapter 8, form 4. Form 4 students yang sudah belajar, maybe you have studied without knowing what you have studied. Because not so much fun and your teacher teach you. Okay, it's okay. Sekarang, untuk pelajar Form 4, they are very clear that this subject basically going to teach you how to mengira untung atau rugi. That's it. It's not a difficult subject. A subject that easily you can score at least minimum of A minus. But to get A plus is difficult. Why is it difficult? Sekarang saya akan beritahu format peperiksaan. By looking at the format peperiksaan, you will know why learning accounting is easy, fun, yet to get A plus is difficult. To get A plus, you must get the right teacher. You must get the right institution that give you a proper tuition. Then you can get A plus. Okay. We see format peperiksaan. Kita tengok format peperiksaan. Okay, before that, we see the result, the national level result for SPM. This is the national level result for SPM in 2019, last year. GPMP, when we talk about GPMP, maybe from 3 students or from 4 students, you are not so sure what is GPMP. GPMP is grade purata mata pelajaran. That means for accounts, the grade purata mata pelajaran is 4.37 in 2019. 4.37 means what? If students get A plus, the GPMP is 0. If students get A, is 1. A minus is 2. B plus is 3. B is 4. That means if the grade purata mata pelajaran 4.37, it shows clearly that in Malaysia, most of the students are getting average of B, grade B for SPM accounts. Same thing in 2018, it was 4.36. 2019, 4.37. And the number of students who get A plus, A, A minus, you see, 34.5% of students are getting A plus, A and A minus. And the students who fail is only 7.9% last year. You will never fail. Tak mungkin fail. Fail means you langsung tak buat apa pun, baru you fail. You go for exam, you don't write at all, then you fail. There's no chance for you to fail. Unless you langsung tak jawab, then you fail. Lulus, you see, 92.1%. Whole Malaysia students, lulus principal account is 92.1%. So this is the best subject for you to sign up. Okay. Saya mahu semua pelajar yang belajar dengan saya jatuh di sini. A plus, A and A minus. And I have produced many students with this kind of results. A plus, A and A minus. Because I have tips for you all before your exam and while I'm coaching you all. Okay, right. Next slide, the same. Format peperiksaan. It's very important to know. Huh? Even though you are in Form 4 or you are just going to sign up accounts next year Form 4, most of the students, they don't even know the format pentaksiran mata pelajaran prinsip perakaunan. How many of you all know? Accounts got how many papers? Berapa kertas? Each paper carry how many marks? What are the minimum marks that I must score to get at least A minus? Yes, very good. Accounts got 3 papers. You are right. Very good. Let's see. Format peperiksaan. Got 3 papers. We see paper 1. Paper 1 is an objective question. 40 question. Normally 20 question from form 4. 20 question from form 5. 40 marks. 40 question, 40 marks. Am I right? But then you see the wajaran. Wajaran means even though you get 40 marks, they only count 20% for your SPM. RST means easy question 5, sederhana 3, tinggi 2. Nisbah dia lah. That means 5 over 10, 3 over 10, 2 over 10. Daripada 40 questions. 1 jam 15 minit. Ini paling senang. Normally students can easily get 32 to 40. So 16 to 20 marks is already in your hand for paper 1. Memang senang. Soalan susah. You see T ya. T, tinggi. Soalan susah hanya 2 per 10 daripada 40. Bermaksud 8 soalan sahaja yang susah. Aras tinggi only 8 question. So easily you can get minimum 32 marks. Paper 1. Okay, leave it. Paper 1 tak susah. Next, I'm going to show you paper 2. Paper 2 is the toughest question. Sangat susah. Soalan 2 ni, you see here, it's a subjective paper. You have bahagian A and bahagian B. Bahagian A got 3 soalan. Question 1, 10 markah. Very easy. Anyone can score. Question number 2, question number 3. Inilah yang membunuh pelajar. Question number 2 and question number 3. If you don't get proper guidance, if you don't do enough latihan, question number 2, question number 3, you're going to struggle. Why? Why am I focusing on number 2 and number 3? Number 2 and number 3 adalah soalan. Soalan apa? I want to ask them, ask students yang sudah belajar. For paper 2, number 2, number 3, why is it difficult? Siapa pelajar form 4 di sini? Boleh jawab. Persamaan perakaunan? Ledger? No, that one all sub-subs way. Very easy. Pelarasan? Can consider. Now, why is it difficult? Kalau soalan tu ada dalam syllabus, it's in the book, why is it difficult? Many students don't even know that question number 2 and question number 3 is LCCI questions. It is not Malaysian question. LCCI stand for what? Ha, terkejut dengar what is LCCI. Tak dapat. Teachers didn't inform you all, is it? That question number 2 and question number 3 is LCCI questions. Joyce? Joyce say, I don't know. Tan Zizi? Tia? Jay Terry? Yes. Not only London Standard. Questions number 2 and question number 3 dibina di London. LCCI stand for London Standard. Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Soalan dibina di London, dibawa ke Malaysia. Dialih bahasa ke dalam ke bahasa Malaysia. Question number 2, number 3. Each question 25 marks, 25 marks. So bahagian A 60 marks. Ini yang pelajar tak boleh jawab. Why Malaysian students always facing problem to answer London question? Every year, pelajar tak boleh jawab soalan nombor 2 dan 3. Why? I'm telling you, London question is not difficult. It's just that soalan nombor 2, soalan nombor 3, dia uji basic. Most of the questions test your basic accounting knowledge. Kalau your foundation level is good, your basic accounting is good, you will definitely be able to answer question number 2 and question number 3. That's why when you are in Form 4, you should learn, develop yourself to understand accounting. Kalau you tak kuasai ilmu-ilmu perakaunan semasa Form 4, you will struggle to answer question number 2 and 3. London question. Why we need London question in Malaysian syllabus? Buat apa? I'll tell you later. Let me finish bahagian B. Bahagian B got 3 questions, 3 soalan. You pilih 2. This is the easiest question. Memang soalan sangat senang because soalan dibina di Malaysia, penuh kasih sayang, soalan-soalan yang selamat, pelajar memang boleh jawab dengan mudah. Okay, ya? RST. Always look at RST. Rendah, sederhana, tinggi. Tinggi, 2 over 10 out of 100 marks. Paper 2 is 100. Ha? That means ada 20 markah soalan, 20 markah yang susah. Dan semuanya dirangkumi di sini. So, don't worry. Don't worry. Kalau you belajar, ikuti kelas saya, I will focus more on this higher order thinking skill question. Prepare you to answer these questions, number 2 and number 3. 2 hours and 30 minutes. Even though the marks is 100, but the wajaran is 60%. Pelajar-pelajar, faham ke? Any question? Okay. Now I explain to you why we need that London question in Malaysian exam. All right. They include London paper, London question in Malaysian exam sebabnya anda diberi pelajar yang ambil prinsip perakaunan SPM. Nama kod kita ialah 3756, ya, prinsip account. You will get 2 sijil. 1 sijil SPM. 1 lagi awak akan dapat sijil LCCI. LCCI, London Chamber of Commerce and Industry, IQ. IQ means International Qualification. SPM, anyone will get. LCCI, siapa dapat? International qualification, who will get? Students who get SPM accounts, minimum of grade B. If you get accounts B, you will get sigil LCCI. Sigil LCCI, they have 3 ranking. Eh? 1, lulus dengan cemerlang. Cemerlang, 2, kepujian, 3, lulus. So in English, they write this is distinction, this is merit, this is pass. So if you get A plus, cemerlang lah. If you get A minus or B plus, they give you kepujian lah. If you get B, they give you lulus lah, just pass. In Malaysia, your grade is B. In London, you just pass. So it shows clearly to us, our grade B for London is just pass, lulus. But in Malaysia, after B, you still have more grades C plus, C, D, E. London, B, pass. A plus, cemerlang. Okay. So you must try your level best, not only to get SPM certificate, also to get LCCI certificate. In order to get LCCI certificate, your overall SPM accounts result, you must get grade B. Clear? So that means you will get dual certificate. That's why we have to include London's question in Malaysian SPM. So after this, you must know, oh, when you open your SPM question, question number two, when you're answering question number two, oh, this is London question. Question number three is London question. But what are the chapters that they're going to test for London's question? Mari kita tengok. This one just bagi anda pengetahuan kepada anda. Mungkin ada tajuk yang you tak belajar lagi, or maybe from three students you don't even know about these chapters. It's okay, I'm just telling you that question number two and question number three that we are focusing actually consists of six topics only. Just six topics. Out of these six topics, dia akan keluar number two, number three. So, penyata kewangan milikan tunggal, this is what you learn in Form 4. Perkongsian is Form 5. Kelab Persatuan is Form 5. Rekod tak lengkap, Form 5. Perakaunan kos, Form 5. Akaun kawalan, Form 4. So, that means you already learn two chapters to answer question number 2 and question number 3. Out of these six topics, dia akan keluar sebagai number 2 atau number 3. So tak susah, dia pun sudah bagi tahu inilah tajuk untuk number 2 and number 3. How many of you aware on what I'm telling today? Berapa orang pelajar Form 4 yang sudah dapat semua maklumat ini sebelum saya cakap hari ini? Ada? You are aware that LCCI question got these 6 topics, LCCI question appear in your SPM paper, ada tak? Tak ada. So you are in the right platform today to know everything, each and every secret, everything that you should know about accounting learning. Okay, my tagline is simple, learning accounting is fun. All right, so you are very clear on paper 1, paper 2, paper 3. This is the best paper, folio. Semua pelajar kena buat tugasan projek. You will do it in Form 5 from March to May, 3 months. Tahun ini pelajar sangat untung because of COVID. Sampai sekarang masih pelajar sedang buat, tak ada masalah. Key in sampai Disember baru kita key in for this year. Next year again baliklah kepada 3 bulan, March hingga May. One folio you do, you get 20 marks. If you follow the criteria yang cikgu bagi tahu, you are very good rapport with your teacher, then you can easily get 20 marks. So 20 marks is already in your hand. Make sure you get 20 because you boleh buat pembetulan. If wrong, you do correction, the teacher will correct back and give you back. You can easily get 20 marks. So you need how many more marks to get A? A minus at least. Kan A got three types of A kan? We have A plus, A, A minus. For accounts, to get A plus, 90 marks and above. Tiada compromise di sini ya. Tak boleh compromise to get 80 something to get A plus. No. A plus for accounts is 90 above sebab kita ada campur tangan pihak London. But to get A minus, 65 marks sudah boleh dapat A minus. So folio, if you already get 20, paper 1 objective, if you can get 30 betul sudah 15 marker. So your paper 2, you must focus to get at least 30 marks. out of 60 lah, out of 60 ya. Yeah? I'm not talking out of 100 because 100 wajaran 60. This one 20 upon 20, this one upon 20. 30 over 60 means paper 2, you need to score 50% chances to get A minus is there. But I strongly believe students who join TransLife Education, you want to score A plus. And also you want to go back with sigil LCCI, Cemerlang distinction. This is our aim. This is our focus. This is what we want to achieve. Right? So you enroll, we teach you in a proper manner, we give you more exercises to do, then you will try your best. Kalau you dapat ikut semua yang kita beri, semua kriteria yang kita tetapkan, should be able to do. Any question so far? Accounts is in BM, memang dalam bahasa Melayu. I will teach in BM and I will explain it in English kalau, because most of the students, they prefer to speak in both languages, right? So bagi anda senang, saya akan ajar dalam dua-dua bahasa. Any problem on that? Not 100% English lah, don't worry. Okay, sekarang my question kepada pelajar Form 3. Apa faedah saya belajar subjek prinsip account? I want to be a doctor lah. Saya tak mau belajar perakaunan. I don't want to be an accountant. I want to be a doctor. Berapa orang di sini nak jadi doktor? Science student. They want to study accounts. Okay. Sekarang angkat jari anda. Doktor boleh kerja di berapa tempat? Satu, doktor kerja di mana? Satu, jawab. Mana? Tak ada jawab. Hospital, very good. If the doctor feel sick and tired working in hospital, boleh kerja di mana? Dua, number two, clinic, very good expected answer. Dua jari, jari ketiga. Third option for the doctor to work. Where can the doctor work? Pharmacy. Pharmacies, they don't need doctors. They need Ali Pharmacy. Oh, your third, ni pun hospital. Hospital, not happy with hospital, go to clinic. Clinic also not happy, go back to hospital. Therapy center, orphanage, pity the doctor. Huh? Don't know where to go, have to go to orphanage. Teaching in university, yes, can, very good. You can be a lecturer, you can work in government department as a pengarah hospital. But you have limited places to go. Now you ambil jari yang sama. Doktor jadi polis lah. You ambil jari yang sama. Where can an accountant work? Accountant kerja di mana? Uncountable. Very good, Kevin. Yes. Di mana ada perniagaan, di mana orang nak tentukan untung atau rugi, di situ mereka perlukan seorang accountant. Accountant can work anywhere. Bank, factory, hotel, hospitals. Also accountant can go. Hospital need accountant. Private hospitals, they need accountant. Private hospital don't run for kebajikan. Juga nak cari untung. Am I right? So, your job opportunities, luas, besar. Furthermore, on top of that, you are given a London certificate. Internationally qualified. You can go overseas and work with that certificate. Or you do professional accounting courses. You do accounting degree. Jadi, tak rugi belajar perakaunan. Even if you become a doctor, you have your own clinic, you doctor, you are the clinic. You perlu somebody to take care of your accounts, right? At least you know, you have learned accounting. So, Ken Haulian, huh? Okay. That's all lah. Saya cuma nak beritahu kepada awak, belajar perakaunan ini tidak merugikan. Even if you want to sign up as an extra subject, go ahead. You are a science student, you want to take accounts extra subject, go ahead. Attend the classes, tuition classes. Kalau cikgu kat sekolah tak ajar, come for tuition classes. We will guide you from chapter 1 to chapter 16. Yeah? 9 chapters in form 4, 7 chapters in form 5, we will guide you. Don't worry. All you need to do, sign up, learn, follow. See how's the lessons going on. Okay, boleh. Baik, saya dah cakap semua. Format peperiksaan saya dah cakap. Saya dah cakap what is the point learning accounting. Semua saya dah bagitahu. Sekarang kita dah masuk sedikit basic accounting. Nak uji pelajar-pelajar form 4. Pelajar form 3 mungkin susah sikit lah. Tapi tak apa, try your best to follow. Because today, I want to test the form 4 students who's going to go for form 5 next year. You punya basic accounting bagus tak? You have learned accounting, right? 12 months you have been learning accounting. Ini bulan 12. So let us try one question. This question akan tunjukkan kepada kita sejauh manakah anda sudah kuasai subjek perakaunan. Try this very first question. Very simple and easy. All you need to do is just tentukan sahaja. For example, more than my form 3 student, it's okay, you can try. Huh? I know you don't have this paper with you. You can just look at the screen and you can tentukan. For example, modal is equity. You can just write in a piece of paper your answers. Kalau you dapat salah satu pun, bermaksud your basic accounting belum strong lagi. Take the challenge, do it now. 2 minit. Nama, do in a piece of paper first. Nanti kita bincang. 2 minit, boleh? You have paper with you, pen with you. Patricia, are you okay? The screen is black. Okay, let me see. Now, okay? Okay, ka? Alright. Cuba make sure you tak dapat satu salah pun. You can discuss with your family members. Done. Hai. Who is that? Why nama you crazy? Done. Saya garanti tak ada seorang pun akan dapat semua betul. Kalau ada, that means you memang born to be an accountant. Take the challenge, do it. Chan Zixin, Chang Yinzin, are you all trying? Junwei, KBH, trying. Ling Hong, Ling Hao Ki, trying. Mabel, Kila, Selina, Okay, boleh kita simak jawapan? Are you all ready? Form 3 students also can try. You can just guess apa dia asset liability. Just guess, it's okay. Shall we try? Nobody saying yes, okay. Okay, kita cuba ya. As I told you, kalau Sabtu salah pun bermaksud you are not ready yet. Belanja runcit is belanja. Upah, belanja. Hutang lapuk terpulih, hasil. Ulangan keluar, ulangan masuk. Apa jawapan dia? Siapa pandai? I'm waiting for your answer. Pulangan keluar. Yes, you are right. Excellent. Pulangan keluar, pulangan jualan ialah kontra. Sewa diterima hasil. Bank asset. Premise asset. Angkutan is belanja. Belian belanja. Jualan hasil. Akaun belum terima asset. Akaun belum bayar liability. Inventory asset. Ambilan is also control. Untung hasil. Peruntukan hutang ragu, control. Susut nilai terkumpul, control. Iklan dan promosi belum bayar, belum bayar. Okay, what's your answer? Iklan dan promosi belum bayar. Liability, very good. Pandai, cemerlang. Belum bayar is liability. Belum terperoleh is liability. Prabayar is asset. Belum terima asset. This keyword, it's a must for you to remember. Belum bayar, belum terperoleh is liability. Prabayar, belum terima is asset. So, belum bayar, liability. Dividen, hasil. Gadai janji, liability. Pinjaman, liability. Komisen diterima, hasil. Komisen diberi, belanja. Perabot, asset. Faedah atas simpanan, hasil. Insurance, belanja. Angkutan keluar, belanja. Alat tulis, what's the answer? Alat tulis. Di sini pelajar akan buat silap, yes. Okay. Ada yang tulis asset, ada yang tulis belanja. Alat tulis is belanja. If the question say inventory, alat tulis, then it's asset. Kalau alat tulis sahaja, belanja. Diskaun diberi, belanja. Diskaun diterima, hasil. Komisen belum terperoleh, belum terperoleh, belum terperoleh is liability. Prabayar, prabayar. Prabayar adalah asset, so prabayar asset. Pinjaman, liability. Susut nilai, you see there are two terms. Huh? Satu is susut nilai. Another one is susut nilai terkumpul. If terkumpul is kontra. Susut nilai sahaja belanja. So susut nilai is belanja. Sewa belum terima. Keyword belum terima. Belum terima is asset. Simpanan tetap asset. Okay, now you have deposit. Deposit, sewa diterima. Deposit elektrik dan air. Okay, we go for this. Deposit, sewa diterima. What is your answer? Deposit, sewa diterima. Asset, hasil, hasil, asset. Are you sure? Okay. Let us see the word deposit. It shows clearly that you are not aware of this word deposit. Deposit. If you come across the word deposit, dia bukan account nominal. Bukan account nominal. Nominal means belanja hasil is nominal. Deposit bukan account nominal. Deposit dia boleh jadi asset atau liability. Asset atau liability. Tak mungkin belanja hasil. How to know it's asset or liability? Simple. Deposit kalau diikuti dengan perkataan hasil, sorry, dengan butir hasil, then it's liability. Deposit diikuti dengan belanja, then it's asset. Liability semasa, asset semasa. Saya ulang, eh? Then you come across the word deposit, dia sama ada asset atau liability sahaja, tak mungkin hasil belanja. How to know asset atau liability? Deposit comes with hasil, liability. Deposit, belanja, asset. Now you tell me, deposit sewa diterima ialah apa? Masih hasil ke? Yes, it's liability. Because sewa diterima is hasil. Deposit hasil is liability. Deposit belanja is asset. Ingat. Because LCCI question, these are the terms they like to use in the exam. Basic. That's why I say LCCI question, they like to test basic accounting knowledge. Now, dengan jujur, berapa orang yang betul-betul kenal semua istilah ini? How many of you dapat semua betul? Siapa? Raise your hand. Ada? Pelajar form 3 ada cuba tak? No. Selina, cuba tak? Form 3 ada cuba. Ada cuba bagus. Ada juga salah. That's why I'm telling you. Semua salah? Eh, takkan kot. Form 3 student is it, Tia? Sikit salah. Nah, so we will develop you. Yeah, walaupun, okay, remember, ingat sini ya. Next year, you are going to be in Form 5. Am I right? So, how am I going to like teach you Form 4 work and also Form 5 work? So, kita akan cuba buat dua-dua serentak. Especially Form 4 syllabus yang basic. Basic pengetahuan asas yang mesti ada tu, saya akan ajak awak terlebih dahulu lah. The basic knowledge must be strong. Barulah kita boleh ajak tajuk-tajuk tingkatan 5 supaya you dapat ikut dengan baik. So ini salah satu soalan yang perlu anda dapat semua betul. The last two saja salah. It's okay Joyce. You are learning in the process of learning. Yang banyak salah, it's okay. Kita akan cuba lebih banyak latihan seperti ini supaya anda sentiasa ingat dan boleh score subjek ini. Okay, go next question. Learning accounting is always fun. Ingat tu. Next question. A simple question. Yet for some students susah kalau your basic is not good. Sekarang soalan suruh awak. Suaikan maksudnya, for example, saya buat nombor satu lah. Beli barang niaga. So, dia match dengan yang mana? Siapa boleh beri jawapan? Beli barang niaga match dengan apa? Yes, you are right. Beli barang niaga ialah belanja operasi. You can suaikan lah. Tapi kat screen ni nak suaikan macam mana saya boleh suaikan. You macam mana nak suaikan. So you just write the answer sebelah dah. Cuba. satu minit, dua minit, try, never mind. This is just to boost your mind balik, ya. Nak ingat balik istilah-istilah perakaunan ini. If this one also you tak boleh jawab, bermaksud you have to get the right tutor to teach you lah. Cuba, nanti saya bincang. Match only, yes. Okay, kita match bersama-sama. Bayar sewa kediaman dengan tunai perniagaan. Apa jawapan dia? Ambilan, you are right. Untung pelupusan aset. Apa jawapan? Untung adalah apa? Hasil bukan operasi. Excellent. Very good. Catatan kontra bagi akaun jualan. Kontra akaun jualan. Kita akan tolak dengan apa? Catatan kontra means tolak. Very good. Pulangan masuk. Kerugian pelupusan aset. Kerugian pelupusan aset. Rugi. Belanja bukan operasi. Bagus. Lengkapan. Excellent. Aset bukan semasa. Jualan. Yes. Jualan ialah hasil operasi. Hasil operasi ada dua sahaja, ya, anda kena ingat. Jualan dan hasil perkhidmatan. Catatan kontra bagi akaun belian. Apa jawapan dia? Pulangan keluar. Very good. Modal. Modal. Equity pemilik. Betul. Equity pemilik sama dengan aset tolak liability. Equity pemilik sama dengan aset tolak liability. Persamaan perakaunan. Semua dah ada. Ada yang tertinggal? A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J. Komisen belum terperoleh. I and J kita sudah tertinggal dari Komisen belum terima. Commission belum terima. Aset semasa. Bagus. Commission belum terperoleh. Belum terperoleh. Liability semasa. Boleh? So ini semua adalah pengetahuan-pengetahuan asas perakaunan yang you kena kuasai semasa tingkatan 4 supaya bila you masuk tingkatan 5 you dapat ikuti pelajaran dengan lebih senanglah. Sebab tingkatan 5 is actually lagi senang daripada tingkatan 4 sebab tingkatan 5 dia ada 7 topik sahaja. Dan 7 topik ini tiap-tiap satu topik dia tak ada kaitan. That means if you don't understand chapter 1, you want to do chapter 2, it's okay. You don't understand chapter 2, you want to do chapter 3, boleh. Form 5, can. But form 4, tak boleh. Why form 4 tak boleh? Let me explain, terutamanya kepada pelajar tingkatan 3. Kalau tingkatan 4 ni, kita ada belajar kitaran perakaunan. Kitaran perakaunan shows to us that awak mesti mula dengan document. You mesti prepare your document. Based on your document, you record dalam buku catatan pertama. Betul? Buku catatan pertama ada berapa? Siapa boleh jawab? Buku catatan pertama ada berapa? Buku catatan pertama ada 6. Buku catatan pertama. Empat, no. Empat pun salah, enam pun salah, tiga pun salah. Buku catatan pertama ada? Okey. 14, Joyce. Buku catatan pertama. Siapa boleh jawab? Okey, buku catatan pertama ada dua saja. Dua, just two. One is journal. Another one is buku tunai. Of course, journal ada pecahan dia. Maybe you count all the pecahan. But when people ask buku catatan pertama, is dua, journal and buku tunai. Buku tunai for you to record all your urus niaga tunai. Cash, anything you buy cash, pick up money from bank and pay, you record in buku tunai. Anything that you pay secara kredit, sorry, beli atau jual secara kredit, hutang, you use journal. Document means invoice, nota debit. Based on this document, we prepare buku catatan pertama. From this journal and buku tunai, kita akan buat ledger. And this one all form 4 syllabus. Document is chapter 3. Buku catatan pertama is chapter 4. Ledger is chapter 5. Right. Daripada ledger, kita akan buat imbangan duga. Imbangan duga is chapter 6. Betul? Then kita akan buat pelarasan. Chapter 8. Lepas tu kita akan buat penyata kewangan, also chapter 8. Pasti kita tutup penutupan. So the whole kitaran you study in form 4. So if you miss document, you cannot do buku catatan pertama. If you miss buku catatan pertama, you cannot do ledger. This one kena belajar sampai habis. Satu kitaran you kena habis belajar. That's why pelajar yang tak kuasai accounts kerana your basic foundation in form 4 tak kuat. Especially this one. Pelarasan and penyata kewangan module 8 form 4. If I give you question now, then it's difficult for me to explain to you from beginning because ramai yang tak tahu format, tak tahu yang mana masuk aset, yang mana masuk belanja. So your foundation kena bagus kat sini. Kena kuasai betul-betul kitaran perakaunan ini. You count pecahan, yes I know. Okay. Jadi kepada pelajar-pelajar yang masih belum kuasai syllabus tingkatan 4, so you kena buat keputusan cepat sedikit untuk supaya you tidak ketinggalan. Okay, kita cuba next question. Okay, kau. Learning accounting is fun. You have to try more questions. Latihan demi latihan you kena buat. Especially basic questions supaya you have confidence. Your confidence level is very high. Kalau you buka, you tahu this account is debit, this account is credit. You know this is asset, this is liability. Confidence level tinggi, you boleh jawab prinsip account dengan baik. But if I ask you one question, hey, perabot, what is perabot? You tak tahu. If you don't know perabot is asset, then you don't know where to put perabot, debit or credit. Because in accounting, kita belajar, when people say accounting, kita belajar apa? Kita belajar debit, credit. Any accounting student kena tahu debit, credit. So if I ask you perabot, perabot debit ke credit? Siapa boleh jawab? Ini semua basic. Perabot is debit. Very good. Pandai. Tapi kalau pelajar tak tahu debit ke credit, that means your foundation is sudah out. Why? Now next question. Why perabot mesti debit? Why not credit? Ha. Siapa yang tetapkan debit credit ini? Siapa orang itu? Who is the person who introduced debit and credit to us? Siapa? Cikgu sekolah awak kah? Bukan. Siapa bapa perakaunan? Siapa bapa perakaunan? Yes, very good, Rachel. Luca Pacioli adalah bapa perakaunan. Dia yang perkenalkan debit credit. Yes, perabot is debit because it's asset. Okay, what about commission diterima? Debit or credit? Credit. Why credit? Next question, beri justifikasi. Kenapa credit? Hasil. You are right. So, pelajar yang belajar perakaunan dengan baik, dia tahu. Kalau debit, perkara yang boleh jatuh sebelah debit adalah aset, belanja dan catatan kontra. Ada dua catatan kontra yang masuk sebelah debit. I will ask later. Credit, we have liability, hasil and we have equity pemilik. Equity pemilik adalah modal. Modal sahaja, equity pemilik. Okay. On top of that, on credit, kita juga ada catatan kontra. Ada tiga. Siapa boleh beritahu catatan kontra sebelah debit? Ada dua. Apa dia? Excellent, Joyce dan siapa? ZZ. Yes, catatan kontra yang jatuh sebelah debit ialah pulangan jualan dan ambilan. That means total yang boleh jatuh sebelah debit ialah aset, belanja and catatan kontra. You have to memorize all these. Don't just remember A, B. Able, able. Ada orang belajar able, able. You belajar able, able, you miss the catatan kontra. You must remember this one as well. Okay, credit. You have liability, hasil, equity, pemilik and tiga catatan kontra. What is that? Come on. Excellent lah. Very good. Some of you really betul-betul tahu accounting. You are good. Yes. On your credit, you have pulangan belian, susut nilai terkumpul. Belajar form 3 pun you can get to know all this. Actually learning accounting is all learning fakta-fakta ini. Peruntukan hutang ragu. By knowing this, orang tanya you, you tak boleh tergugat. Accounting student, when people ask you, promosi. You tahu promosi ialah belanja, debit. Boleh kan? Boleh kita cuba. We try, ask a few questions. See how many of you boleh tentukan debit credit. Saya nak panggil nama. I don't know which one from three, which one from four student. Never mind. You can try. Wong Dao Lung. You from four ke from three? Wong Dao Lung ada? Xin Lin? Yong Jun ada? Never mind. I just want to ask a few questions. Sikit saja. Huh? You just tell me debit atau credit. Boleh? Kita cuba. Gadai janji. What's the answer? Gadai janji, debit. Gadai janji. Credit tak boleh. I tell you what. Accounting adalah professional subject. Professional subject means everyone must give the same answer. Gadai janji is credit. Why? Correct, credit. Winnie. Why is it credit? Joyce, Xin Lin. Liability. Gadai janji is liability. So on your credit. Hutang lapuk terpulih. Debit or credit? Hutang lapuk terpulih. Credit. Excellent. Why? Hasil. You are right. Faedah atas simpanan. Faedah atas simpanan. Credit. Why? Hasil. Pelaburan. Pelaburan. Debit. Why debit? Pelaburan. Pelaburan. Asset. Pelaburan adalah asset. Bukan liability. So it's on your debit. So this is when from 4, from 3 students. Huh? Inilah yang kita akan belajar. We will introduce all this istilah to you. We will make sure you know which one debit credit before we allow you to count untung atau rugi. Supaya you tidak tersilap kira. So learning accounting is actually really, really fun. If you get the right teacher lah. Okay. Seterusnya, I think I want to try a very last question. This is document perniagaan. For each urus niaga that I have written, can you name the right document that we are supposed to use? I have put here 22 urus niaga. Dokumen sumber, ada dua jenis dokumen. Eh? Dokumen sumber dan dokumen bukan sumber. Bukan sumber ada dua sahaja. Dokumen sumber ada berapa? My student, my accounting student, everything must be in your fingertips. Dokumen bukan sumber ada dua. Dokumen sumber ada berapa? Pernah tahu? Pernah ambil tahu? Yong Kai Ing? Very good, Akila. Exactly. 17. Sharp. Tepat. Sangat tepat. I didn't expect y'all to know. That means you are really smart. 17 dokumen sumber. Okay. Now, cuba tentukan. You can just scribble in a piece of paper. Nanti saya bincang. This is our last question. Don't worry. If you don't know, it's okay. I will teach all this in detail in my classes later. Cuba, just scribble in a piece of paper the answers. Boleh rujuk buku. If you have books with you, can ask your parents. Boleh bincang dengan rakan sebelah yang pandai. Dan sudah. Shuilin, Cheryl, Rachel, are you all trying? Bayar sewa menggunakan cek. Apa dokumen? Fikir. Think. Nama dokumen yang sama boleh berulang. Because you have 17 documents only. The question got 22. That means boleh berulang. So you don't worry. Ini senang, 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 senang. Tak ada yang susah. Saya sedang cari yang susah. Tak ada. Ini mungkin lah, mungkin susah, mungkin. Senang, senang, senang. Senanglah, tak ada yang susah. Okay, done. Mesti keratan cek, tak boleh guna cek. Cek sudah bagi, tak ada bersama kita. Document sumber means document untuk rujuk. If you have given the check, what we rujuk? We rujuk keratan check. We don't rujuk check. So check will never be our document. Keratan check sahaja. Okay, sorry, I can't read your name. It's in Chinese. Okay, bye. Faham, eh? Yang tanya soalan ni faham ke? Saya sudah explain. Can I know your name? Li Chen. Okay, Li Chen. Baik. Alright. Mari kita pergi dengan cepat. Beli dan jual barang secara kredit. Beli dan jual barang secara kredit. First answer. Very good. Invoice. Excellent. Beli dan jual secara tunai. What's the answer? Very good. Bill tunai. Upah atas belian dikenakan selepas invoice dikeluarkan. Anything after invoice, what is the document? Nota debit. Very good. Pulangan. Pulangan barang. Pulangan barang, nota kredit. Yes. Invoice terkurang catat. Nota debit again. You're right. pulangan barang daripada pembeli tadi kepada pembekal, as long is pulangan nota kredit, tak kira daripada siapa kepada siapa, pulangan mesti nota kredit. Bayar gaji pekerja, gaji, got specific document for gaji, what is that? Bayar gaji. Yes, very good. Voucher pembayaran. Bayar sewa menggunakan cek. Keratan cek. Kecil sangat. Okay. Terima dan bayar tunai. Terima dan bayar resit rasmi. Very good. Terima dividen. Terima dividen. Makluman kredit. Very good. Charge bank dikenakan oleh pihak bank. Anything from bank is makluman debit and makluman kredit. If duit masuk, makluman kredit. Duit keluar is makluman debit on bank side. Tunai di bank dikeluarkan untuk kegunaan perniagaan. How you withdraw money from bank to use in bank? No, it's not memo. No. You want to withdraw your company's money from bank. Bring it to your office. No, neither, not slip-pindahan bank. Slip-pindahan wang all, you transfer money from office to bank. This one, you withdraw money from bank to use tunai di bank dikeluarkan untuk kegunaan perniagaan. Slip bank, slip-pindahan wang all, you transfer money to bank. You withdraw money from bank. Come on, I'm waiting for the right answer. Yes, finally, Kevin, it's keratan check. Very good. Beli aset bukan semasa dengan tunai. Beli. Beli aset. Dengan tunai. Boleh pakai invoice ke? Dengan tunai. Yes. Beli apa pun. Asalkan beli secara tunai, mesti bil tunai. Beli secara kredit, mesti invoice. Ini semua basic, mesti tahu. Bawa masuk aset. Document. Memo, you are right. Dokumen direkodkan untuk perbelanjaan runcit. Ini kalau kita memang pandai. Perbelanjaan runcit. Voucher tunai runcit. Excellent. Bukan semua pelajar boleh jawab. Ha? Ini mesti pelajar yang ada pengetahuan perakaunan yang sangat baik. Depositkan tunai ke dalam bank. This one cash to bank, not keratan cek. Keratan cek means you take withdraw money from bank. Yes, you are right, slip bank. Wang dibayar kepada pihak ketiga. Payment voucher, no. Slip. Yes, slip pindahan wang. Pihak ketiga means the correct word is slip pindahan wang. Keyword for pihak ketiga. Dokumen dikeluarkan oleh mesin ATM. Nota kredit? Nine. Very good. Slip transaksi perbankan apa? Dua jawapan tu kena gabung. Jawapan Joyce dengan jawapan yes. Slip transaksi perbankan elektronik. Itu baru betul. Sorry. Wrong pen. Slip transaksi perbankan elektronik. Baru betul lah. Very good. Dokumen dikeluarkan oleh pembekal perkhidmatan. Catering. Ya ke? Perkhidmatan. Perkhidmatan seperti telefon. No. Perkhidmatan astro. Bil bayaran. Very good. Pelanggan hotel. That's the keyword. Pelanggan hotel. If you go to hotel, they keep track of hotel punya pelanggan. Yes. ZZ. Folio pelanggan. You are right. Silap pen. Folio pelanggan. And the last one, dokumen dikeluarkan oleh mesin daftar tunai. Siapa pandai? The last one. Mesin daftar tunai. Keluarkan. Exactly, return. Slip daftar tunai. Done. 17 jenis dokumen. You keep these notes, you will know fungsi tiap-tiap satu dokumen. This is chapter 3 done. Today you have learned chapter 3, all the nama dokumen dengan fungsi dia. Chapter 3, you just need to know nama dokumen dan fungsi, that's it. Chapter 4 baru you apply the dokumen. Alright, pelajar-pelajar, saya rasa saya sudah sampai ke penghujung jalan. Thank you so much for being with me. I think saya sudah cubalah explain to you why you have to learn accounting, sijil apa you dapat, sedikit basic because I don't know some of you form 3, some of you form 4. So I have to teach a very basic thing hari ini. Saya telah laksanakan tugas dengan baik. Saya percaya anda pun sudah ikuti dengan baik. Any question you can ask me. Kalau tidak, saya jumpa anda dalam kelas tuition saya bersama anda. Thank you so much. See you all. Learning accounting is fun. Good night. Bye-bye. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay, so. Hi. Hey, why? Oh, you are here? Because you are taking account.